On 15th of July 2020, Twitter was hacked. High-profile account on Twitter posted a tweet to ask their followers to send bitcoins. Twitter said it was a social engineering attack, while other sources claim it was an insider attack. No matter what the real cause is, human factors were involved. This brings up an interesting and important question. How easy is it for somebody to tweet as you,
as an outsider?
On 12th of June 2014, a Twitter user with the handle DaGuhun published a tweet, and almost immediately, every other Twitter user started retweeting the same tweet. It turns out everyone who saw the tweet automatically retweeted the tweet without the user knowing what has happened. In just a matter of minutes, hundreds of people had already seen and retweeted the tweet. The issue here was cross-site scripting, abbreviated XSS. Basically, when you tweet HTML code, Twitter is supposed to show it as a test instead of rendering it. But TweetDeck had a bug that if you tweeted something with an emoji in it, that tweet will be rendered as HTML. A malicious tweet would have been able to inject JavaScript in the tweet and perform actions on your behalf when you are viewing the tweet, like accessing your DMs. What DaGuhun did was they included JavaScript code in the tweet so that you would retweet it when you saw it. And if your followers saw it, they would do the same. And if their followers saw it, they would do the same too, and so on. I've personally found a few XSS issues on Twitter, and so did other people. From my experience, I can say that there are still plenty of XSS issues on Twitter waiting to be discovered. So XSS is pretty bad, but what if you wanted to tweet as someone like Donald Trump? Obviously, he won't be browsing Twitter a lot, let alone reading your TikTok memes tweets. So the chances of him seeing your malicious tweet is slim. On 26th of February 2017, bug bounty hunter Ketherish submitted a security bug to Twitter that allowed them to do exactly that. They noted that Twitter Studio had an API endpoint for tweeting photos and videos. The endpoint takes several parameters, and the important ones are user ID, which is the ID of the account the tweet will be sent from, and media ID, which is the ID of a media to be tweeted. The first thing they tried was change the user ID to another account they don't have access to. It didn't work because that would be a disaster, right? But the reason might be different from what you think. The API endpoint returned the error, user ID is not the owner of the media. Now there is another feature on Twitter Studio which allows sharing media to another user. The next thing Ketherish tried was to upload media, share it to another account, then change the user ID, and boom, they were able to tweet as any user. The issue they found is what is referred to as an insecure direct object reference, or IDOR. Basically, Twitter did not properly check if a user is authorized to access or perform actions on behalf of another account. IDORs are easy to find as all you need to do is find different API endpoints and try to change some IDs. In fact, you could do much more than just impersonating another user. Imagine if there was an IDOR that allowed changing the email address of another user. It could allow completely taking over the account by resetting the password. Ironically, since they are easy to find, most IDOR issues are already reported through bug bounty platforms. There are other much more sophisticated ways that could do the same, but hacking can sometimes be very simple. We hope that by describing these attack vectors, we can better illustrate the impact of various bugs to bug bounty hunters. Leave a comment if you have any hack or bug you would like us to cover in the future.